send it off in a letter to yourself. Sorry, guys. Hey, Bitch Talk episode 236 for your ear holes. Ange and I are on location again at one of the finest drinking establishments in San Francisco, and I'm not going to say the name because I don't want anyone else to be here. So you're joining us at one of our favorite literally hole in the walls.
Yeah, this is as divey as it gets, and I recently found out about her because of you, Aaron. Thank you very much. But if you ever want to be in a cave and just say fuck the world, this is the place to be.
Yeah, that's why I love it. And also, I was going to kill people here, but now they're gone, so we can now record. Anyways.
Well, one thing that's really depressing is, one thing that I loved about bars back in the day, this is aging myself because I'm not a millennial, is their jukebox. And you would judge a bar based on a jukebox, like, oh, I love this bar because they have this, 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 A, B, C. And now, with the invention of internet jukeboxes, bars have lost their soul. And sure, this is just the most recent bar to lose its soul to the internet jukebox.
Yes. I agree. They had the old-timey jukebox that there was a binder to correspond with the jukebox, just in case, because some of the discs, they were either there and they didn't have an explanation to what it was, or there was a disc there and you didn't know. I don't know. Anyways, you had to go by the binder to figure out what you're playing. So anyways, you guys, really quickly, we'll do the housekeeping. Head to the new and improved Bitch Talk podcast website. It's beautiful. There's new pictures of us that my two team members probably don't like, but I think they're great. If they really want them changed, fine, we'll change them. But it's bitchtalkpodcast.com. You'll find all our socials there. I'm going to please beg you to rate and comment on iTunes, because that just lifts our visibility on iTunes. So please do that. We've been around since 2013. There's no reason why you haven't done that yet. We're also on Stitcher, Google Play, and SoundCloud. So visit us, say hi, make a comment. Also, what I really want is an email from you. Oh, Fats Domino's playing, RIP. Sorry. So email us at the Real BT Podcast. I don't even think that's right. The Real BT Podcast at gmail.com.
The Real BT Pod.
The Real BT Pod at gmail.com.
Who knows things?
Ange knows things. So anyways.
I wanted to give a shout out to Annika Wu, friend of the show, filmmaker, documentarian, and all-around badass. She's the one that took the photos of us that you'll find on the website.
Right. Thank you.
It was an awesome day. We went to a brewery. We had some beer, and we were all nervous because we hate taking photos, but Annika is a true professional, and they're beautiful photos. I don't want to say they're bad, but you know, you're always going to be judgmental of...
Ange had a serious tan line, so when you look at that photo, there's not a camisole underneath her shirt. That's a tan line, you guys. Ange tans hard.
No, Annika asked that I could move the strap of the camisole, apparently, and it just, that's flesh.
Right.
Sorry. But anyway, I'm walking to New Orleans. Can I just say that Fats Domino was the best, top three performers that I've seen at Jazz Fest in New Orleans. I went 3 years in a row. And that man, RIP, with his big-ass belly and his grand piano, just sang, and he was the essence of what New Orleans, what makes New Orleans beautiful. So
this is very topical, because in my notes on my phone, I wanted to say congratulations to New Orleans for getting their very first female mayor.
Yes.
In 300 years of being a city. Yeah. I'm going to grab my notes real quick. Her name is LaToya Cantrell. She's a Democrat. And I can't wait to go back.
Yeah.
The woman's in charge.
The Times Pecan.
Yeah.
Okay. That's the newspaper. No, that's all.
Oh, okay. No, that's one of our favorite cities probably in the world. And now that they have a female mayor, I cannot wait. So congratulations to New Orleans. But I just want to apologize that we've kind of been on and off the air. Our producer extraordinaire has been across the world in different time zones. And so, you know, Wi-Fi isn't always... hot everywhere, like in America, but we're back. We're back. We ate a lot of turkey. We drank a lot. And my pants are tight. So I apologize for a little bit of a drought of Bitch Talk. But if you follow us on the socials, I'm still trolling people. Don't worry about it.
Still bitching.
Always bitching. So how are you, Ange? This is a basic bitch, obviously, because we're at a bar. So. in the Tenderloin.
I am great. I just got back from Santa Cruz. I have a really great friend that lives out there. And it's really funny. She has a daughter who's only a few years younger than me, but is her spitting image, right? They're both just like crazy badasses, can just like chat your ear off and have stories for days. And it's funny, like her and her daughter, I love hanging out with them because they just have this dynamic, and they're like, they know everything about each other. And it was crazy, like while I was there, her daughter was telling us a story about, and she's only a couple years younger than me, so this is like my homie too, right? She's telling us a story about how she was super fucked up one night in her early 20s. And they were, like, doing coke and partying at a friend's house. And she found what she thought was a rock on the ground. And she asked her friend to break it up. And she snorts it. And it was an Altoid Wintergreen.
That would hurt.
So now she's, like, forever. Like, and the reason it came up is because, like, we were offering Altoids. And she's like, oh, no, no, I can't have one of those. Remember that time I snorted it, Mom? You know, like, she's telling her mother this. And I thought it was so awesome. I was like, wow, how crazy is that to have a relationship with your mother that, like, she just knows your dirt, and it's just, like, all out there. She doesn't judge you and whatever. And I thought about that for myself, and I was like, because my mother and I couldn't be more opposites, right? Like, I would like to think that I have some of her best qualities, but we're just opposites. And
Your mom sits at dinner and is praying for our souls.
So. Yeah, I mean, she wanted to be a nun, but then she decided to have 5 kids instead. I was like, all right, from nun to Slutsky, I don't know.
Well.
No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, she was married.
She was married.
Guys,
she was married. But, hey, she decided to go all in. I go all in if I decide to do something.
Yeah,
so maybe
yeah.
That's one of our... Anyway, I digress. I don't know. I thought, what do you think? I mean, like, just for your mom to know that kind of dirt. I know you and your mom have a really great relationship, but,
yeah.
Like, would you tell her that kind of dirt?
No.
No, you don't have that kind of dirt. Sorry. Mama Lim, she doesn't have that kind of dirt.
But I don't need to know all of hers either, so it's
yeah.
A little quiet in here in the bar. don't want to really yell. No, I think boundaries are good.
Well, I appreciate my relationship with my parents because it's simple. Like, we love each other, right? We're down, we support each other, right? And then it's like, cool. And then that's it. And I don't have to stress. And I have a lot of friends that their relationships are more complicated. But I don't know, there's some beauty in that.
No, I can appreciate it. I don't hate it. It's just not my relationship with my mom. But I think we know enough about each other that, I mean, maybe one day she'll hear about all the other stories that I haven't told her yet. But, you know, I want her to have a really great idea of me. Then I'll just bring it down a few notches. Maybe in another few years. Maybe by 45. I do have a good mom story, though. I have to tell you. It's something.
Bring it.
Something kind of only a mom or a dad would do, and I'm saying this with the most love for my mom, because I love her to death.
And me too. I love you, Mama Lynn.
Yeah. But I get a call over the weekend, and she's like, you're right. And I'm like, what am I right about? She's like, we do have black in us. And I was like, well, okay, well, please.
Elaborate.
Please explain. So I guess there's some app that's a thing off of Ancestry.com. I want to say it's called We're Related or something like that.
I mean, it's like a 24andMe or something. It's different?
Okay. It's free.
Okay.
I think what they're doing is really, and what my boyfriend has said, is they're data mining. So you either sign in on your own or Facebook. So a lot of people just sign in through Facebook because it's easier. But then once you do that...
If it's free, I'm already hesitant. My sister did the one where you pay, and I doubt that one as well.
Well, yeah. Well, all the Mormons own that information, so take it with a grain of salt. So anyways, they tell you who you're related to, but famous... So I'll tell you who is black in my family. Barack Obama, Michelle Obama, Michael Jackson, Bill Clinton, because everyone knows the first black president was Bill Clinton. Just kidding. He wasn't. But everyone said that. And Britney Spears, who's obviously not black. But that's who we're all related. That's
Shut
who we're related
up.
To.
Your family is related to the Obama. What are you talking about?
I will say this as a side note. I think I've said this on the podcast before, but maybe not with you. I do think that we're related to Barack Obama only because his mom's side of the family, who's white, is all from the same
Kansas.
Town, but the same town as my mom, which is a podunk town. So I would say sure, But then Michelle and Barack are related to each other and to us? No. And Michael Jackson? No.
And Britney? Okay. I don't know how to feel about that. That's some... After my sister got this... what's the one she paid for?
23andMe?
No, she paid for the other one. Anyway, she paid for one of the ones. You take a sample, you send it in. And it didn't say that we were at all of Spanish origin.
Oh.
Which my whole life, I was told that I was of Spanish origin. My dad's adopted, and his father was a rich lawyer, mestizo, which means mixto, right? He was half Spanish, half Filipino, so he had light skin, light hair, so everybody thought he was super handsome. Anyway, we thought that was our dad's father, and he's been adopted since then, but... It said we had no Spanish blood, so I was like, fuck you, it's all a lie.
It's all a lie. I mean, sure.
And this is a free program, so...
It's a free app. But it was hilarious. The first thing out of her mouth was, you're right, there is black in us. And I'm like, okay.
So your mom's all in. She's down.
She's in now because it's the Obamas. And I was like, well... whatever. So that's my mom's story.
That's amazing.
I'm trying to think what else has happened in the last... I mean, Thanksgiving happened, but it was just food.
Well, I have... okay, so my sister went to Hawaii for the week, and her friend gets Blue Apron.
Right.
And he forgot to cancel his subscription, so I got his three meals for the week. And I have to say, they are good, and I enjoy following the recipes, and... eating things that I wouldn't normally eat, but I would definitely not order it for myself.
I hear they get kind of repetitive.
Well, I don't know. I only had it for 1 week, but it's just so much waste. I mean, so like, you will have 2 ounces of red wine vinegar that you need to use for the sauce, and it's a little container. And then you have like 1 ounce of mayo, and that's in a container. And you have a celery, and that's in a plastic bag. It's just like, everything comes in a plastic bag, and then the whole thing comes in a box, and then it comes in this thing with like two things that can freeze into ice. And then like, people just... toss that, you know, because they get it every week, and it was just super wasteful. Maybe this isn't good because Blue Apron sponsors a lot of podcasts.
Whatever. We're not going to ask them for money, by the way.
No, but here's the thing. I liked it. I really had fun making the meals for my friend and I, but it's just super wasteful. I don't know. And the meals were good, and I'm excited to keep that recipe because I'll probably use a couple of the sauces for future reference, but yeah, Blue Apron, I get it. I get why people do it, but... it's just a lot of fucking waste on a weekly basis. It's a lot. Anyway.
I'm of the camp, and I'm a weirdo, but I've always loved cooking. I've been cooking since I was a kid and been the weirdo watching Channel 9 on Saturday mornings, which, if you're a little old school, there was, like, Julia Child on Saturday mornings. There used to be Jacques Pepin. There's just, and I, you know, nerd, but I loved that shit. But you can go to the farmer's market on the weekday or weekends. We're lucky in San Francisco, we have them almost every day of the week, but in major cities and around cities and in farm towns, there's farmers markets, guys. Go get your own stuff. Go on the... I feel like we're so loud when there's no music. That's why I'm going really low. Char's going to really like it. You can go shopping for yourself. I don't think it takes that much time.
I think the mic is on the other end, too, but I don't remember. Oh, this is a good song. No, but I had fun. I had fun with the recipes. It's fun because it just, you know, tells you what to do. There's no thinking involved. But yeah, it's just super wasteful.
Maybe if you're starting to cook, it's a good guide. But then if you're really interested, like, I think your sister's friend is a cook. Like,
he's legit. He fucking deep fried the turkey, and I was like, yeah.
Really?
Oh, this is my first deep fried turkey in my life.
I've never had one.
Oh, God. The skin gets crispy towards the neck and the anus.
Okay. I didn't know you were eating turkey ass. So.
No, that's where the skin gets crispy, because it's on its own.
It's taut.
Exactly. No, I'm telling you, towards the neck and the... And I was eyeballing it, because it was a group of us, and I was like, I need to get on that crispy. It was like chicharron turkey style, but with like seasoning, and he injected the turkey with like butter, soy sauce, Worcestershire seasoning. Yeah, he injected it the night before.
Ooh.
Fucking legit.
Cool. I don't... Anus. Okay, I didn't know that there's a turkey anus when you buy the turkey. Where is that? The cavity?
Wait, what are you talking...
Okay.
How do you not know where the... It's where you put... When you fill the sturfy...
No. It's not... We've had a couple Jamesons, guys.
I called it a sturfy. No, it's where, it's when you fill the sturfy... Or the
stuffing. This is what happens when we go on the road.
No,
the
I'm
stuffing.
Telling...
The cavity?
Yeah,
no, that's not where the anus is. Okay, anyone, can you email us?
Where is the anus? What are you talking about?
There's no anus.
It's the ass.
Yeah,
Where's the fucking...
Hey, you guys, why don't you email us at therealbtpod@gmail.com and let us know where you think the anus is.
I'm sorry, what are you talking about? How is that not the anus?
That's the cavity.
So
that's
where's the anus?
Yeah, exactly.
Where you go in via anus.
That's what she said.
You're not going in through the neck.
Okay.
No, I don't understand.
Yeah, we'll Google this afterwards. Or someone can tweet at us. Angela to be pecked from Canada. I know you're listening. So if you want to let us know where the anus is on a turkey, please do.
What are you? No, I don't need to know. I know. One neck is...
That's
one
right, because you like that skin.
One end is the neck. The other is the ass. What are you talking about? Where's the confusion?
I don't know. I'm a confused about a lot of things. I got Italian all of a sudden. we're gonna duke it out in the Tenderloin about where the anus
is.
Where else
is the anus?
I don't think where that cavity is. It's where the anus is.
Where else would it be?
Okay, you're right. I don't know. But where they stuff the giblets and everything?
Yes.
That's the anus cavity? No.
Where else is it? There's a hidden hole?
You guys were playing Where's the Anus? We're playing Where's the Anus on the turkey?
And the diabetes
anyways,
bar and server. I mean,
it's perfect.
I mean, we're like in the TL.
It's topical.
That much.
No, Thanksgiving. Let's go back to Thanksgiving. I've never had a deep fried turkey. I have had a turducken once.
Ah.
It was fine. No big shakes. We've never done it. We've only done it once. And it was like, we did it. It's fine. We didn't have any political conversations, which was really key.
Thank God.
I didn't bring any nasty woman wine because I'm saving it for Christmas.
I think that would be better appreciated as well.
Right.
You gotta bring it to a crowd that's gonna appreciate it.
Right.
And not prejudge it.
Yes.
Because
there's,
it's fucking delicious.
It is. That Pinot. Pansu Pinot. You guys, go on to nastywomanwine.com and order some wine for the holidays. Even if it's not a gift for yourself. When, like, you're cooking and you have family and they're
treat
talking
yourself.
About politics. Pansu Pinot. Like, I still have a rosé in the fridge and I have the bubbles waiting for Christmas. Once you hear this, you've heard the Golden Gate Fields episode. But by the way, if anyone's in the Bay Area and thinking about what they want to do for New Year's Eve, Golden Gate Fields is open. Did we talk about this?
Yes.
Oh, well. But not on air. So, there might be a Bitch Talk podcast field trip back there on New Year's Eve. We'll get back to you about it. But Ange might be there.
Yeah, if I'm around. I'm still up in the air.
Oh. Okay. Were you thinking about going?
What do you want from me? I'm just a bird flying about.
Okay. All right. Speaking of birds flying around and other female candidates.
Don't bring up Prince Harry. You going to bring up Prince Harry?
I don't care. It's whatever.
Keep it fresh.
You know what I like? That she's older.
I like that she's brown. She's American. So I did have a chance after all.
You did.
I mean, what the fuck?
Yeah, you're about the same age.
Thanks. Yeah, I had a chance. But I'm not mad about it because good for him. He found some flavor. And I don't want to live in London anyway, so.
Yeah, but I don't think he's going to live there.
What are you talking about?
I thought that they said something about he wants to live here in America. But then he'd be denouncing everything. I mean, you really had a chance, Ange.
Are you kidding? No. No, no, no. She's quitting her career and she's going to perform her royal duties.
Oh, over the pond?
Yeah.
You mean have babies?
Which for me, like... well, no, actually, that sounds kind of amazing.
Yeah. I mean...
I was going to be like, no, I want to live my life. I want to be my... And I was like, well, living in a castle with Prince Harry.
Yeah.
doesn't sound too bad. Okay, let's move on.
Okay. Did you know that there's a Democratic candidate for Michigan State Attorney General? She's promoting a lot of her, what would it be called? Sorry. Is promoting her lack of a penis as a qualification for office in a new ad. Her name's Dana Nessel.
I saw that. She's like, you don't want sexual harassment? Okay, well, elect a woman.
Yeah, she had, I think, the pictures of Weinstein, Roy Moore.
Maybe.
Dump.
Franken.
Al Franken in there. But it's kind of hilarious, and I'd vote for her. I'm going to throw some money her way, I think, if I have it, when I have it. But
Michigan's an important state. Yeah.
But yeah, if you want to Google it, her name's Dana Nessel, and she is running for Attorney General, which is kind of awesome. I'm not hating on it.
I think it's really funny, and I just want to bring up, I mean, this kind of connects the two stories. When you so Aaron texted me, sorry about Prince Harry, because she knows how much I love him. And I assumed that he was going to get married, but my first thought was, okay, I hope he hasn't molested somebody, sexually harassed somebody, or died. Because whenever you find news about somebody famous, those are the two things that they've done. They've either died or they've sexually harassed someone. So I was actually relieved to find out that he was engaged.
Yeah, I didn't even think about that when I sent that to you. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you fucking sent me in a spiral because I was in Santa Cruz in the mountains, like, not having service. And then I was like, what happened to Prince Harry?
Right. No, I'm sorry. Nothing bad. And I'm hoping that this woman, Meghan Markle.
Markle.
I'm pretty sure he won't be dressing up as a Nazi for Halloween anymore after marrying her. So good on her. I was trying to think of what else. I just want to say, I know I've mentioned it before, but if you haven't listened to Greg Proops in his podcast, please do. He's probably more of a feminist than I am at this point. And I just love him. So please give him some love. Download his podcast. He's actually going to be in San Francisco doing stand-up and his podcast at the end of December. We have tickets already. So if you want to see some ladies from the podcast, when I say ladies, I mean me. But if you want to come see us, we'll be there on the 28th. Also, a friend of the podcast just announced that he's going to be, I think, at Punchline or Cobb's, Frankie Quinones. Yeah, in December. So, you know what? I'm going to hit him up and see maybe if he'll be on our podcast. But you guys should buy tickets to see him also. That's hashtag CholoFit, y'all. So, he's a local guy that went down to L.A. Well, he's back and forth from L.A., but he's doing big things down in L.A., so when he comes up here, I think for 3 days in December, just buy a ticket and go. He's fucking awesome, and he supports all local artists, literally artists, comedians, whatever.
And people of color. Yeah, mm-hmm. All of the above.
Speaking of, our friend Dino is working it in L.A. and just posted pictures with, you know, Anna DuVernay, just hanging out, just chilling, just talking about people of color and, you know, them in the business and Filipinos in film.
Wow.
Yeah.
Excuse the hell out of me.
Yeah. So that's why he doesn't call us anymore. But it's okay. I know he loves us.
Did you put this on?
I did. Is it okay, Amber? Okay.
Sorry, we just...
No, I was saying, are you ready for a little Power Girl jam?
Yes.
Always. That's our bartender, Amber.
Sorry, the bartender, if you haven't heard.
Power Girl jams, like, are you ready?
I'm always ready.
I was fucking born ready for that shit, Amber. Come on. Don't give me that bullshit.
I apologize to everyone else in the bar. I apologize to everyone.
Whoa, live for the bar.
All right, part two. Here we come. We're going to wrap this up because we're a couple Jamesons in, but this is a really good bitch talk podcast, I have to say.
We had to take a sabbatical because the bartender was in need of my artistic abilities.
Also, some songs came on and we just had to sing and enjoy them. But I forgot to mention that I've been having dreams with past guests in them.
Whoa.
But nothing, obviously, nothing sexual, but weird.
Well, that's not obvious, but anyway, go on.
So, okay, Sasha Lane just appeared in one. We had her on last year, American Honey. She's fucking awesome. If you find her on Instagram, she has like a million followers
now. And she's killing it. Like, when we first met her to now, I mean,
She's doing okay. She's a model now and doing really avant-garde stuff. Just find her. She's really cool.
And kicking it with What's-His-Butt from Moonlight.
Oh, God.
One of the... He played the teenager
in Moonlight.
Chiron. Anyway. Yeah.
So they're hanging out, but whatever. And then I just had a dream about Zoe Lister-Jones. Well, who wouldn't?
Probably a lot of people dream about Zoe Lister-Jones. She's pretty beautiful.
Yeah, and now I'm not even... Oh, you were also in the dream. She bought a camp for kids in Connecticut. Oh, yeah, it was very specific. But we were wearing heels in the camp. And we're like,
Fuck this camp.
Yeah, and I was like, Zoe, this is not really feasible for us. Do you see us? We don't wear heels.
Why is camp and heels? Don't dirt and heels? No, it's public enemy number one.
But she kind of wanted us to run it, and we're like, all right, we'll do this for you. No problem, girl. No problem. We got your back. So, I've been having dreams about our past guests, but all of our guests are great, but we love Sasha and we love Zoe. And Zoe loves us.
Absolutely. Well, they both follow us. They follow us. No big deal.
Yeah, no big deal. But yeah, I've been having dreams about our past guests. I don't know what that means. It's weird, whatever. But we're gonna wrap up this episode 230. You guys, 236 episodes of Bitch Talk. If you didn't know, now you know. We started this podcast in 2013. We've had a lot of amazing guests. I was telling Jeff, oh yeah, we've interviewed Aparna and Charla, no worries. We've interviewed Frankie Quinones, no big deal. We've had Robert Pattinson, people have heard of him, not heard of him, but we interviewed him. It's not a big deal or anything, but we've done that. So I just want to ask our listeners, not only just rate, comment, share with your friends. Maybe they like us, maybe they won't. But that's the point of this podcast. Either you like us or you don't. As with all bitches. Duh. Also, I'm trolling people on Instagram as Bitch Talk Podcast. So if you want to get entertained, just go on to Joey McIntyre from New Kids on the Block's Instagram, and you can see where I shut down some dumbass fucking Trump supporter, I'm guessing. Anyways, it was fun.
All right. Well, on the flip side, I read the Celestine Prophecy lately.
Oh.
Which I know it came out in the 90s. I'm a little late. And anything that's popular, I try to stay away from for a hot minute.
I haven't finished it.
You haven't finished it?
No. I started in the 90s.
It's a fucking short book.
Yeah, I started in high school. Just kidding. I haven't.
In high school.
I'm in the middle.
Okay.
I was still in high school in the 90s. Fuck you.
She got real mad.
Yeah. I'm not a millennial like some.
Anyway, no, let's talk about for this upcoming year, it's the holiday season, it's a new year. Let's talk about energy, the kind of energy that we're putting out and the kind of energy that we want and the kind of people that we want to connect with and be open to. And an interesting point in the Celestine Prophecy is they talk about being open to these messages that are sent to you from the universe. And I'm like, motherfucker, I live in San Francisco. If I converse with every crackhead that came up to me, it would be a different story. But keep that in mind. Just be open to when you catch eyes with somebody and there's a moment there, maybe you're supposed to talk to them.
I'm catching eyes with Ange right now, but we're already talking.
Oh, we're
so
two
that's
inches
weird.
Away because we're recording from my phone, so it's already a little creepy. Yeah. No, but I'm saying, how often do you just kind of meet eyes with somebody or really feel a connection with and you just kind of let it slide? I don't know. Maybe entertain those situations and talk face-to-face with people more often. I think you'd be a lot happier.
Yeah, I will concur with that and say that maybe put your phone down. I'm guilty of not putting it down. But put it down and talk to the person that you're next to. It works, people. I haven't gotten to where I am without doing that, actually. So maybe 2018, put down the phone for 30 minutes. Talk to someone next to you. Doesn't matter who it is. A stranger can be a friend. How about that? But yeah, I'm excited for December. We already have a lot of good guests lined up. One is actually running for Lieutenant Governor of California next year, which is really exciting. And that's what we're here to do in the next year, is to really prop a lot of women up, people of color up, and also Bitch Talk up. So thank you for listening. I know this is a long ass episode in a bar, but that's why you guys follow us and you love us. And
It's not that long.
Okay. And thank you for listening to episode 236 of the Bitch Talk Podcast. We'll see you soon.
Bitch, please.
Or you need another beverage.
All of the above. I will help you and I need another beverage. Oh.
Did that? Was that? Is that recorded?
Yes.
One in the Oh my god. It won't stop.
It's 9176 Ange and Pager code duh.